Hello friends, in this video I am going to show you my new design. This is the VALTRACK-V4 vehicle tracker. This version was designed because we only had 2G versions of the trackers, the VALTRACK-V2 and VALTRACK-V2B. VALTRACK-V2 was for personal or asset tracking purposes and V2B was for vehicle tracking. So we designed this version 4 because there was a lot of demand for 4G enabled tracking devices from the Western countries, where 2G has been phased out and only 3G and 4G remain now. So we designed this. So this is how the design looks now. The stickers have also arrived. So I just attached one of the stickers to the enclosure. So these are the stickers. Originally, the enclosure lid would have looked like this without the sticker. This is the same size enclosure in a thinner form factor. The thickness is less. The space available for the battery is also less. So we chose this enclosure particularly because I can support a cable gland here. So this is an 8mm cable gland from Takachi enclosures. So we needed this extra height for putting the cable gland to make the box waterproof. So let me show you how it looks inside the box. This is the inside of the box. As you can see here, this is how the board sits on this. There's a connector for the battery connection. We can connect an internal battery here for backup purposes. And there are two antenna connectors. One is for the cellular and the other one is for connecting an external GPS. So GPS external active antenna for the GPS. SIM 7600, this is the SIM 7600G. This is the global band version of the 4G module series from SIMCOM. There is SIM 7600E, SIM 7600A also, which cater for European and American markets. And this G version is a globally certified module which will work on any network all over the world, be it 2G, 3G or 4G. Okay, so we use these standoffs in the bottom. We use these standoffs in the enclosure for increasing the height of the PCB so that we can place the battery in the bottom. I just disconnected a wire. Okay, so this is how the board looks. And as you can see here, this is the STM32WB55 MCU. It's a Bluetooth MCU with the Bluetooth 5 support. It can also support Zigbee and Thread protocols. This is the Eeprom for configuration data storage and also to store some pings which might be lost in long interval applications if there is no network available. And this is the same GNSS model which was used on the VALTRACK-V4. This model has been giving good results compared to the SIMCOM versions. So we are also using the same thing here. Even though there is very less ground plane available here, and it's sitting on in a crowded place, at the corner of the board, still it gives very good reception and is able to acquire the GPS sync within 30 seconds. Since the board is very congested, we added this SMD pads where the power connectors are connected. So we are soldering the power wires directly here. The battery connector is soldered here and the power connector is soldered here. There is a PTC fuse added to prevent inrush of current when there is a short circuit. And there is a diode for reverse polarity protection. Okay. And this is the first stage of the system. This is the power regulator. This is a TPS 54240 switching regulator. It can handle voltages up to 3.5 to 42 volts. So the power input rating has been increased significantly in this design. And this whole part is related to this IC. And the next part is the addition of the MP2617 here. This is the battery charger chip with the power path management, which will be able to charge the internal battery available in the system when there is no power input available. Suppose if someone removes the power input from the main vehicle battery, the MP2617 will switch to the internal battery and keep the system running for some time. And this inductor and this whole part is related to the MP2617. And we have provided the same one SOS switch here. This can be used for entering into Bluetooth mode or some other emergency alert purposes. It's configurable. So whatever user asks for, we customize that in the firmware and give to them. The same nano SIM connector is added here for the SIM insertion. And the Bluetooth antenna is again the PCB antenna. This is giving very good results. We get up to 150 meters line of sight range. So we have kept it as it is, as it doesn't add anything to the cost of the product. And Eeprom again for configuration storage and ping storage in case of signal loss. There is this flex connector which we have added again for programming cable connector for connecting the programming cable to connect to a JTAG like a STLink or J-Link. This is the accelerometer, no change in this. This is the LIS 3D 3-axis accelerometer, can be used for motion sensing. And the same RGB LEDs which are present in the previous asset tracker design, the V4MF, are added here. These are used for indicating the battery level, red, green, blue, and the signal level, red, green, blue, and also the GPS sync status. So it will only use the red and green. And we added two pads here just in case as an auxiliary output. Suppose if someone wants to control the ignition remotely, then we can use this MOSFET driver to control the relay connected to these pads. So we can draw out this MOSFET driver output and bring it through the cable gland. We have enough space here in this. So we can draw out one more wire. Ground is already present, so we can draw out one more wire. So these are the major highlights of the design. This is just a level translator chip, TXS series, for converting the voltage levels of the MCU, which are at 3 volt, to voltage levels of the SIM7600, which is at 1.8 volts. 5 assembly pads are provided for programming the boards in production, wherein we don't need to use the flex connector. We can directly program the board using these pads, using pogo pins or ping pong connectors. I don't know what you guys call them. They are spring-loaded contacts. Okay, I think most of the points or the highlights of the hardware are covered. So the main highlights I want to repeat is the higher input voltage range up to 42 volts and backup battery operation using the battery connector and MP2617, and also we have RGB LED indicators, Bluetooth 5 and 4G module with global connectivity support. So those are the major highlights of the design. We have also made one more version. This is one version of the board which we made recently during the lockdown. We were locked down for almost 2 months here. This version we have called it as VALTRACK-V4-VTS-IO-INT-LTE, which signifies IO means we are controlling the LEDs by IO pins of the MCU instead of the IO extender which we used earlier, the PCA9224. So we removed that part because there was not much space available and we wanted to reduce the cost. And there were some IO pins free because we removed some input and outputs. That's why we are able to control the LEDs directly by the IO pins. So the IO and INT means it has internal antennas for the GNSS, and the antenna for the cellular which we are using will also be internal to the enclosure. It's a little bit of flex connector. So and the LTE is the LTE version, which will support fallback to 3G and 2G when there is no 4G network available. We also made one more version, which is the VALTRACK-V4-VTS-IO-INT-LTE. This version will have the same features except that it will support the narrowband IoT and CAT-M1 networks with the help of the SIM7070G module. So I will update more on this. I will make a separate video on this with the product feature highlights in the maybe in the next video. I will explain about this product. So that's all for now. If you have any questions about this product, you can drop me a mail to ravi@valtrack.com. And if you have any technical questions, you can post it on my forum, www.embeddedadvice.com. Oops, I broke it completely. There is space for about maybe 400 to 500 mAh battery here, which could easily give a backup of about maybe about 2 to 3 hours continuously. So that's all for now. If you have any questions about this product, you can drop me a mail to ravi@valtrack.com. And if you have any technical questions, you can ask it on my forum, www.embeddedadvice.com. Do visit my blog also at ravi.com, where I post the same contents as in the video in text version. So that's all for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.